morning. I'm Kill the Bit. I'm your host for the 9-to-5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. This time I'm back with another special edition of Let's Play Classic Let's Play featuring Grand Theft Auto Online DLC The Chop Shop, which came out a few days ago on Tuesday. So this is going to be Gaming Walkthrough Episode 3. Now, in the previous stream, I had completed the Duggan robbery where I stole the Bravado Gauntlet Hellfire from them, and I had the option to either sell to Yusuf Amir or to keep for myself or to sell it for scrapped parts. So instead, I decided to give it to Yusuf Amir, and I got paid about close to $340,000, GTA, of course, and I had to bring it over to the dock so it can get shipped out in a shipping container. So I'm going to be focusing doing the prepping and possibly executing the second heist of the other vehicle. And from my understanding, you can only do the vehicles that are featured per week. So the three vehicles that are there, that's it. And then until next week, which in this case will be Tuesday, a new set of three vehicles to either to steal and flip for parts or to sell to Yusuf Amir or to keep for myself. So, with all that said, let's get on with this day's stream. So grab a snack, grab a drink, grab whatever. It's time for Let's Play Classic featuring Grand Theft Auto 5 GTA Online, the Chop Shop DLC, Gaming Livestream Walkthrough Episode 3. Let's get it on. And as always, I like to do in a private lobby. I'm not trusting of everyone. And that goes without saying. The glasses up. And if you're idle for 15 minutes, you get kicked out of the lobby. So I just go in a close friend session. I can invite people that are in my Rockstar Games social clubs friends list. Occasionally, I do play the table games. Only the one I like to play is blackjack because it's easy to understand. And every so often the three-card poker, but not so much the roulette because it's obviously risky. But one thing that isn't risky is the lucky wheel, which I'm about to spin right now. And you can only spin per once a day IRL.
Ready to fill that void in your soul for a moment? Shop for the hottest new fashions at the casino store.
So 24 hours from now, I go another stream. I mean, 24 hours from now, I'm going to spend the money. Thank you. it's a feature of upload when the news of short form content on how to properly navigate GTA online. Going back to the salvage area.
Hey, where's Bobby at?
And if you send me an invite for like an old heist, I'm talking about like the Lasers. First heist, I'm not gonna accept it. I only do like the much newer heists or Caio Perico, the major ones that pay off the most. Bye. Yep. So the cars that I had chopped up are gone. See, like for example, this person's trying to send me for like the first ever, at least one of the early GTA heists, and I'm gonna...
Alright, we might be ready to move on this thing. If you want the work, you'll get a knock on your door any minute.
Now, I'm gonna go into the heist board here, but first I have to register as a boss in this case. CEO. So the next heist I'm gonna do is this one. Only cost $20,000.
Okay, nice pick, boss. Nice car. Now, here's how we're gonna get it. This may come as a surprise to you, but you aren't the only close personal friend I got in organized crime. Your boy Jamal's connected. You ever hear of King Tiny? He was a major player in the Ballers. OG and everything. Anyway, he got out and now he does a whole podcast about the life. Got like 20 million followers on Snapmatic, man. Yeah. Legit. Now, I met him at a house party up in Vinewood one time, and we just clicked, you know? I let him use my yacht and my penthouse and all my cars and my credit cards and everything.
Oh, dear.
Brother from another mother shit, you know? Anyway, the cops pull him in all the time. They got him in Mission Row Station right now, facing some pretty big charges. Now, he says if we break him out, he'll tip us off for a car. And not just any car, man. This is like the personal, pimped-out car of one of the biggest gangsters in Los Santos. Yusuf will love this shit. So, let's scope out the station and see what we can do, right?
Mission Row Police Station.
What's up? So, this job is gonna get a little sweaty. If we want that car, we're gonna have to bust my boy King Tiny out of this police station. It's gonna be tough, seriously. So we'll need a bunch of intel so we don't end up in there with him. He's a bit of an escape artist and the guards hate him, bro. If any of them get shot, they're gonna take him out in like 2 seconds. And I, for one, don't want to shoot up a police station just to get a car. So, we'll need to do this non-lethally. Got it? That means no guns.
Yeah, we'll just use a stun gun. It's hard to get out of here, it's a maze. Top down. By the way, this is my new ride that I bought. It's like a Ford Mustang. Convertible. lot of the GT cars are modeled after real life vehicles. Like the if this is a vapid vehicle, Dominator GT or whatever, GT, it's modeled after the Ford Mustang. Vapid is the Ford Motor Company in a nutshell. Let's see, this person sent me his invite for his old ass eyes. No, thank you. We got better things to do. That was pretty good. I love how it sounds. Now, I do a stream with the GTA story missions as well, so I'll be doing that later. That's gonna be the next one coming about 3-6 Eastern Standard Time. So keep a reminder on.
Not this shit again!
yourself.
You take back what you said!
I'm taking you fucking down! I didn't mean it, okay?
Fuck you!
Oh, hi, Mom!
Definitely be able to drop a knockout gas grenade through one of these vents. That'll put a lot of the guards right on their asses. But we'll need some armor to make sure you get through the rest of them alive.
Get the hell out of here!
We are en route! Air support en route!
Hey, man.
what you need.
Go to hell!
See ya.
I'm guessing you don't want a back rub. How can I help? Oh, hey, you're in trouble. Okay, I'll deal with it.
Okay, let's go! Shoot!
fuck do you think you're doing?
Greg's overhead is killing him. You follow?
Excuse yourself right now! I'm so done with this! Loser!
You're gonna fry for this shit! You piece of trash!
What the fuck?
Let's go! What's going on?
Don't do it! cheese.
I'll kill
you. What do you mean this isn't the Chinese place?
You lame ass!
Dude, I just want my soul and cheese.
Oh shit.
Hi. What service are you looking for? I take it this isn't purely a social call. Of course not. You're in trouble and you need my help. No problem.
person stopped sending me invites. Do this again. Shit.
What's up? So, this job is gonna get a little sweaty. If we want that car, we're gonna have to bust my boy King Tiny out of this police station. It's gonna be tough, seriously.
All the time, but something about breaking into the headquarters has me scared shitless, no lie. I want to make sure we go in there knowing exactly what we're doing. I'll go over there and get some pictures we can make a plan out of. The roof, the air vents, that's our way in, so start with that. And get some shots of the choppers they have too, because we'll be using one of those to get up there. Lastly, the rear exit, so we can make sure we don't end up in one of those cells with my homie. Nice. So that's the chopper we need to get up there. Anything else and we'll never make it onto the roof without them calling all the fucking backup on our ass. Oh, we'll definitely be able to drop a knockout gas grenade through one of these vents. That'll put a lot of the guards right on their asses. But we'll need some armor to make sure you get through the rest of them alive.
this guy sure doesn't want me to get. That was an accident.
For sure. My homie knows the internal code for that door. Been watching guards go in and out for weeks. Let's make sure we get some weapons stashed over there, just in case you need them for when you get out.
That on, you can give anybody shit and not worry about the repercussions.
Finally, I did it right this time. What this does is... stuttering. Pissing me off.
Okay, I gotta admit, I didn't know how we were gonna be able to pull off a jailbreak. But after scoping out Mission Row, I got my arms around this shit, you know what I mean? We got this, so let's get everything ready. We need to get you kitted out and the guards kitted down. And the most important thing is to make sure you have a getaway car stashed nearby, so y'all can get out of there once you're, out of there.
I'm definitely gonna get everything I need. I guess we'll take the police van.
Alright, Mission Road locks down hard after dark, and we can't exactly do this shit in broad daylight. The way I see it, there's only one way in. The roof. How you feeling? Ready to steal a police chopper? Yeah, I thought so.
So, we need a police chopper. My first thought was we just tune into the Weasel News, find the chopper chase, and go grab it. But then I figured stealing a helicopter on live TV was not the best start for a clandestine operation. So, we're gonna hack the signal box for the news feed they're prepping for later today. We'd be like an hour ahead of broadcast, but that's all we need.
Go to the Weasel News building.
Thank you.
Because I was confused with this.
Okay, I see the chopper in the footage. Sending you the location now.
Guys, I know what that is. I know what that is. It's up in the tunnel.
You knew that was going to be bad.
Thank you.
like to say that if you are enjoying the stream, you like the content I'm bringing you, why not consider following and subscribing to the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel for more Let's Play classics such as Grand Theft Auto 5, Grand Theft Auto Online, Sleeping Dogs, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, and many others. I greatly appreciate that. What's up? You take good care of it now. Take good care of it now. Keep it nice and tight for me. Alright? Let's get my vehicle. This is probably about the 10th, 15th time this guy's been sending me invites. For heist, I don't want to participate in. Please. Find somebody else. Find somebody low level that has never done a heist ever. Alright, split. Shake the city. There's some people complaining about how come there are no turn signals in GTA. I mean, why do you care about turn signals about your car that you're not gonna drive in real life?
Chopper. Now, when you're ready to break into the precinct, I'll make sure it's in position.
Hey, it's...
Check on my other businesses.
Yes, Tasha, I do remember what happened last time. Why you not arrested me?
Also, I'm gonna do some winning comments.
Because that bitch
vehicles. But like I was saying before, there's some people who play GTA that wish there were turn signals. Turn signals? Come on. Ever in a video game? Let alone GTA? That's too much. It's not real life driving, it's a video game. So I'm going to 2 o'clock with this stream. Might have more than enough time to pull off the heist today. That's kind of what I'm aiming for.
Okay, breaking someone out of jail means a lot of confrontation with seriously serious police. And we're not trying to get in there and start a war over a car. So we gotta get you set up for success. Now head to the IAA lockup I'm sending you. Now, these dirty little shits have been hooking up the highest bidder with all sorts of crazy equipment. So we're getting in on that. They got everything you need, like armor and gas grenades. See? I got you.
It's probably gonna get the stash. So. Forgetting how to get out of here. I could just turn something to say I'm busy, and I'm not accepting any invites. Let's see. Cities and towns in the GTA universe are based off of real-life streets, real-life locations, but they're given different names for the sake of a parody or, you know, parody. There's people who live in Los Angeles who can immediately right off the bat identify the geographical locations of places of interest, streets, towns, and districts and whatnot. See, there's my person. Is that Spy 72? Underscore 72. Break into the lockup.
I got cut by my own knitting needle last night. The knitting circle was at my house this week, too. I know. Usually we're knitting when that happens. We tend to use razor blades for the sacrifice.
Jack off!
Trying to grease them. IAA, they're going down.
Fuck you!
Like I said before, I miss making a shit.
Move it up! Jesus Christ! Fuck it! Ah, shithead!
Get them in the head, they're dead.
Down your neck! Man down! Man down! Go
there! New battle line.
I'm out!
promising that could be in the first one. Try another.
Here I go!
Fucking stick! To cover!
Here you go is right. Here you go, dead.
Fuck you!
Holy cow!
Oh, we found it. It's in here.
Shithead!
It's over! Prepare to be amazed! And then dead!
Get cover! Screw you!
Whoa. Regroup!
To escape, good way. This thing's very
you cocksucker! What the fuck?
Fuck you!
Perfect. How would you like to go to an Outlaw or a salvage yard and you see like a tank? Like an old decommissioned relic of a tank. That would get a lot of business. It's a track business.
What's up? Take care.
Invite him to the salvage. guess we're gonna need some help with this.
Okay, I'm all for boosting our chances of success, especially when we're doing something this dumb. Now, Mission Row Precinct needs to be as unprepared as possible for this shit. Let's take out some of their equipment, like their gas masks, for example. Drop by the LSPD lockup I just sent you, and we'll take it from there.
Like your tag simply says spy. Stories of the women.
I'm about to kick your ass!
You can't be here! Back up!
Let's go inside and take him. Alright. Now we gotta destroy this shit. Okay, get back.
You take it down? Once you do, find the shipment schedule so we can locate the rest of their equipment.
Where's the manifest? guess it's gonna be probably in two parts. If not this whole episode. Because the first thing we had to do is set up to break this guy out. So that he can get us the intel we need. So we can steal the second ride.
Should be way easier to get out of there now. Not that I thought you would die, cause I didn't.
You forgot?
Hey, so I'm thinking you might need some weapons once you're outside of the police station, just in case things go south. Now, I had my buddy over at Ammunition arrange a little spread for you. All you got to do is pick them up.
Maybe behind the counter. try to go this way. Maybe here. Oh, hold on. Yeah. Gonna get some armor anyway.
Are you looking for defense or offense? A very wise choice.
Let's try this again. Unmarked weapons. Okay, good. Split. Stay on the
stunt, man.
So, I'm thinking we'll use stun guns to take care of any cops you run into. Now, we're not there to shoot up a whole precinct, and we don't want anyone to shoot my guy during the escape. Now, I got a tip on a security guards who should have some stun guns in their car. I got the license plate here for you.
What's up?
Hey, see you around.
Already had Trevor, we've already had Franklin, but why not Michael? Come on, Rockstar. disappoint us no matter what. It's like being in an uneasy relationship with someone who constantly lies to you, but no matter what, you still stick by them. Yeah, that's the kind of relationship most of us have with Rockstar Games. Under-delivering and under-promising, but at least they've kind of delivered with this DLC.
Okay, so we need to get you a tough car for the getaway. Tougher than usual. I heard about the auto shop sitting on a lot full of stolen vehicles. Probably some kind of gang working there. Sounds like they're fair game to me. If you can make it out of there.
Oh, it's here. Come on up. Strong on this shit. Kung Pei, eh?
Fucking jerk!
That looks like Plastic Man. Look at him.
I just shot Plastic Man.
It's Plastic Man. Y'all don't know nothing about that. Old school Saturday morning cartoon from back in the day. Based off a comic book character, I think. I think he was the pre-Mr. Fantastic. Destroy the getaway ride, so be careful. Let's have two getaway rides. That'll be good. Move in. You guys see, don't see your dumb ass?
Moron!
Yeah, go on. Which one? I like this one. Take this. I like this one. We'll take two. Take one. You take what I take, what was split. Ooh, I love this.
What's that?
I'm gonna buy one of these. Flip it out like so. We got two getaway rides. This is sweet. Let's hustle. Ooh, you got some nice too. I like it. I dig it. Let's go. make some awesome shit.
Okay, the Buffalo SDX. I respect that, bro. What's good? What's good? Okay, bye.
Tell you what, you drive. Get the thing moving. Back to the sandwich yard, yo. Thank you.
You need something?
All right, we're ready, and we're doing this. We're raiding a police station full of cops to rescue a repeat offender to steal a car from an armed gang. Whew, that's what we're doing. Okay.
Everything good?
Laters.
You all good?
Can you hear me? How about now?
Yeah, I can hear you. I just can't hear you with the game on. You're just real quiet.
Yeah, because I'm streaming, actually, and the keystrokes might accidentally, you know, change the camera views from OBS. So.
Oh, okay.
So this
I gotcha.
Is how we can communicate. And plus, since I'm not doing the in-game voice chat, because Rockstar Games, as you heard, has now introduced AI, so you say even the slightest thing, no matter what it is, you're going to get kicked out. Which is unfortunate.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and stupid.
Out of all the crap they say in-game?
Yeah, like, I mean, it could be anything. I mean, it could be anything from politics, or it could be anything about, you know, dispelling or discounting say anything about Corona, the vaccine. If you say any comments that they don't like. Just think about it. That's the thing with going on with social media. With many of the social media platforms, is that they'll set you on the count of you saying, you know, if you're disputing about Corona, the vaccine, science, whatever, climate change, who knows?
Right.
I mean, just imagine when, and it could be out of context, and then you can find yourself in the doghouse.
Right.
So that's why.
Oh, I gotcha.
In addition to that, too, you know, because that's why I always have the Rockstar Games voice settings none. I'm having that now. You know, I mean, you have it.
So, so are you straight? Are you streaming on Twitch right now?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. So you got any users?
Well,
I mean, you got any watchers?
Well, like not, probably not. Maybe not now, as I know it, because I had took off the there's a chat feature in OBS. I kind of closed out because there was a bunch of spammy stuff yesterday, so I'm accidentally closing out the chat of that. But you know, I have about 14 followers on Twitch.
Okay.
Yeah.
And they can hear you, but they can't hear me?
More than likely, probably. But, I'm not really sure if anyone's on here, like, you know, anyone who's watching, you know, but still, you know.
But they could hear me, yeah.
Yeah, it's a good possibility that they could hear
me. Oh, okay. So, that's fine.
So, yep, so keep stuff to yourself, you know, so, you know.
Nah,
you know,
man, I'm clean, bro.
Whatever.
You've gamed with me before, I believe.
Yeah.
What were you in a server with me or
yeah,
no?
I'm in a server with you. It's just the fact that by the way, did you get some masks? Did you get yourself a mask? Because I just purchased a mask set, so we're good. So the mask set means we got masks for everybody, even if it's just two of us. So
I don't think I need to purchase anything.
Nope, you don't. So I got. So you can apparently buy the mask as a set. So that means is that whenever we do the heist, they'll have masks for at least everybody, at least up to four people, I guess. So it's
okay.
A new DLC, not sure if you're aware of, where Yusuf Amir appears in GTA Online, and he's got this chop shop business, and he's got his cousin or nephew, I'm not sure who, who's running point for these robberies. And we're stealing cars for, of course, Yusuf Amir, and we have the option to either sell the car to use it, which I prefer, or strap and scrap and chop, sell the chop parts.
Yeah, I bought one and got one car, but I haven't done all three yet.
Yeah, I just finished that one. I did the first one successfully yesterday and actually sold the car to use it. So the next so the first course of this op is to free the guy out of the pen. I mean, the police station, and then he'll give us the intel for what we're going to need to steal the car. But I'm only just going to deal up to just getting the guy out and then just doing some repo missions, and that's it.
Okay.
So I'm going to split the stream actually in second part and two parts, like a part one, part two, but that's probably going to be like tomorrow for the second part, which of course we're stealing the actual ride.
Right.
Because I only just go up to about 3 hours on the stream, plus I stream other games that I'm doing walkthroughs for, especially Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which Ubisoft gave away for free, and I got the game for free. Oh, it's on account of the fact that I tried to download Red Dead Redemption 2, but unfortunately, the video card, I don't meet the requirements, and it ends up crashing, but at least I still have the game. So as a result, we decided to use us do Assassin's Creed Syndicate, even though it's a game, and this is Let's Play Classic, it's my series, it's like games that are like 8 years older, 8 years or older. So and then I'll have a separate Let's Play, which will be for like current gen games or whatever.
Gotcha.
So I've been playing a whole bunch of games, and I've even played Mad Max.
Okay.
And it's a lot of fun.
That's cool. What server were you in with me?
I was in the, I'm trying to remember. Because I think maybe because I probably met through TGG. Through the Gaming Gorilla.
There you go. Okay. I couldn't remember if you were in that one or in Burns.
I was in that one.
TGG?
Yeah, and usually I go with TGG, you know. He's like a transparent, modest type person, as far as I know. But
yeah.
But you know, ever since. By the way, what did you think of the trailer for Grand Theft Auto 6? Because I know you have to have seen it.
Yeah, I think it's. I mean, I'm kind of excited about it. I've heard they're going to come out with. They're going to come out with it on console before they do PC.
Yeah. Yeah, unfortunately, because I think it's so that they can make sure that, you know, the everything's all scrapped out, you know, just to test the waters before they release the PC, which will probably...
I think they usually do that anyway. Yeah. It's just a bummer for PC users, but...
I know. And this is going to be the first time I'm actually going to not necessarily have a new Grand Theft Auto game, because I've been following the series since Grand Theft Auto 3. And I was getting the day of releases. I remember Grand Theft Auto 4 released in April 29th of 2008. I was there for the midnight release, and I was actually interviewed by the local TV station back when I was in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
People
at my job said that they saw me. So there's old Jamal. And the one thing I got really tired of is that, I'm in today, not to say today, but with the recent DLC, is that they're playing the song, the licensed song, and I turned down the music volume and everything. And I would just wish that Rockstar Games and many game developers and publishers would just have a stream-only option so that us content creators...
Work together. Yeah.
So us content creators don't have to worry about licensed music and copyright strikes or notices and whatnot. So anyway, let's go do this thing. Let's go do the thing.
Yeah, I was in another server. I'm still in Gorilla.
Yeah.
But I got in this other server, Burns, and a guy from Canada created it. Mm-hmm. And it's actually a good vibe, you know? But they got a couple of people in there that's just so negative. Mm-hmm. And I do this for fun, you know?
Yeah, and besides, I play games just so we don't get into stuff that's, you know, hot button topics and stuff. And that's but the thing too is that many games like to get on the social, you know, on the social tangents of certain stuff. Like even like many of Ubisoft's games, you know, I can get the whole social thing and all that. Like I've been playing Watch Dogs Legion, but then with the recent update, they made it so that RTX, the game now crashes, so it makes it unplayable for me now. But the social stuff, of course, is when London, England is taken over. But it was a provocateur event. And it was also a frame.
Right.
That's one thing I can just tell you about it. But other than that, I did like the game. But one thing that really upset me is that some of the puzzles and something to do with drone-related type stuff.
Yeah.
Like this one area where you actually had to use a micro drone. And if you crash the drone, there's certain ways of how you can end up losing the drone. Like, it's like if you're going inside of an actual computer mainframe.
Mm-hmm.
So, here's what we're gonna do. So, like, if you're going through a computer mainframe, there's areas where you had to watch out for the fans and also the heat. And if you get too close, and since I'm on a weak processor, video card, it's kind of difficult to try to navigate. got stuck on is that when I'm trying to defeat one of the main villains, it's that you can't switch out the character. Because I end up having to use a character that has non-lethal weapons. Because the boss character is difficult to defeat unless you have high-powered weapons to defeat the boss character. So, as a result,
gotcha.
I end up uninstalling that. But I still, I still look forward to it when I eventually upgrade the game. When I eventually come around upgrading the PC. Because when it comes to consoles, I do believe you are a certain limited, especially when it comes to content creation. Because when it comes to using OBS and using some other, like internet browsers and what have you. Because I also do like to do my own video editing. But I do most of the video editing on tablet.
Alright, you got this. Now just try to get on the roof as quietly as possible.
And most recently,
not
I
sure
did
how, but, you know,
a YouTube short.
Cool.
Where two clips from Assassin's Creed, one in the Fight Club and one in being taken down the gang leader before the gang war. And I did it so brutal, it was so gangster style. Because I used Power Director.
Right.
But it got about over nearly 15,000 views.
Oh, wow.
We're gonna be using stun guns here. So, by the way, we can only use stun guns. So let's try to not. Let's go find that. Oh, hey, you.
LSPD 6!
All right, let's roll out the next phase. Gassing the guards so we don't have to shoot anyone. Throw some of those gas grenades through the air vents.
Oh, yep. Kinda. So let's get up top here. Wanna throw the gas? Do the others. There's probably multiple locations, so.
Yeah, there is four of them.
Two is that this is gonna also be uploaded on YouTube as well. That was gonna end up being a replay on YouTube. So I'm only 48 subscribers. Is that we took out all the resources so that they would be better, what do you call it? And plus we're taking them down with stun guns anyway, so this should be an easy extraction.
Oh yeah.
Once you're inside, remember, stick to the stun guns. I'm not taking a life sentence over a car. And we don't want no panics cops shooting anyone.
Yeah, I'm just glad we got a new DLC for a little bit.
Even the last DLC before that was somewhat, for the most part, not well received. It's weird is because I'm stuck. I can't move my character. So hopefully you'll get the person out.
I just can't remember where the keys were.
Yeah. Hopefully it doesn't need my input. But it's like, I'm stuck on the roof. I can't move my character.
throwaway. I don't know why. Like, I can move the camera, but I can't move my character.
Once you got your hands on those keys, get them over to my boy's cell. He should be on the lowest level, aka the basement. The gas won't have made it down there yet, so be ready. Keep it non-lethal.
So when I play this back on through Twitch, I'm gonna check to see if whether or not if your voice picks up on the other end. Because the way I see it is that
with the OBS recording, if there's a computer nearby, it'll take out the emergency locks. After all his escape attempts, they don't take any chances with him.
Your voice will probably not be picked up. But because only my voice can be popped up, can be heard, that's what I'm hoping for.
Right.
In the interest of protecting individuals and protecting users, I want nothing necessary to be any audio to be leaked for any.
Hey, over here! You Jamal's partner? Then let's go, baby, let's go!
Because if only my voice is being picked up. Because my voice is being picked up.
Okay, the back door is the quickest way out of here. I've been memorizing the code everybody punches into that lock. Let's hit it. I got a chopper waiting nearby.
30 minutes left on the screen. I'll use the opportunity to do the repo business and just get the cars on. Because once your safe goes up to 250, $250,000, that's what you can do, just like the nightclub.
The getaway car is still exactly where you left it, or whatever you want to use to get the fuck out of here and over to Tiny's chopper.
Get us away from 5-0. I'll tell you what's good with the car once you drop me off in one piece.
I'm waiting for the NPCs just to shoot me. At least I can move.
Alright, we're on the road. Oh yeah, he's trying to get Rockstar to pay.
Yeah, Lindsay Lohan claimed that Rockstar Games used her image, which they kind of did, but you know, I don't think they were inclined to compensate. And more likely Rockstar Games is probably laughing at, you know.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah, look at that guy. Oh yeah, meanwhile, in a related story, the alligator walked into a Walmart. You know, plus compensation too, and probably a roasted chicken. But then they showed the alligator running around in the convenience store. Look at, they're shooting at me and I can't die. I'm just like a practice dummy to them. Look at this. Take hold of this.
did the same thing with the video. Certain songs that I choose to pick.
Give up now!
I already picked the flashes and I'm gonna call it.
Oh my god!
I'm gonna go see this song.
Hold on, somebody's trying to call me on Discord, I can't hear you. No, let him go, let him go. Huh?
Dude, I'm a practice dummy. Oh, covered in blood. I'm not even dead. Dude.
Yeah, boy! Hopefully not. Oh wow.
Yeah. And this one is back in the cool game village at the time in 1868. You can have up to 5 of them. You can destruct them to take out enemies.
So I'm a 2020 gamer. I started gaming in like 2020. See, my son used to play this game, and my daughter used to play this game. And when I started I do a lot of iRacing, online simulation racing, and on the side I play this game. I play a couple other games, but I'm not a huge gamer. But I like gaming because I got a bad back, so it kind of helps me have something to do, if that makes sense.
Of course. Yeah. You know, there's a game that actually does heal. He played at MIT with a professor named Professor Jake. He's back in the public into EV.
Right. Oh wow. Oh yeah. I met Jerry the King Lawler one time.
He's from Louisiana. And he was known for like hitting.
Okay, two things. One, you're in gang territory, which puts you in serious danger. And two, you'll be dressed as a cop. So you might as well have a target on your back and shoot me now, painted on your forehead. Oh, I don't have a solution. I just wanted to say, good luck.
Yeah, I gotta go get this, You probably not much under my age, bro.
Yeah, I'm 46.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. I've been playing video games since house and the pixels, right? I can
yeah.
play the video game E.T. and turn off the entire place. And incidentally, those cartridges went across to the New Mexico landfill. They had too many of those. To bury their mistake, they decided to bury
Well, I still got my whole game system with all the games, paddles, and everything.
Mine
my Atari.
As a gamer too, he usually likes first-person shooters, but he also served in the U.S. Army.
That's cool. I got an old Sony PlayStation. Still got. I used to play Madden on and stuff.
Hang on. It's almost time to restart. No, it ain't. Johnny got us. No, now I guess we are still in the vehicle.
Yeah, I am.
Wait, I'm gonna
Except the gun that they give me in the car is like a one shot.
If you still in the vehicle, then I won't have to make a second part.
Do you want me to keep going? I stole a wrong car. I'm like,
I'm still bloodied up. They shot at me 1,000 times.
Ooh, that's rough! I forgot all about stealing the car. After we get done with this, I need to take a little break.
Yeah, that's fine, because I'm about to hit this right now. That's 2 minutes anyway.
Sorry. Okay, cool. Yeah, yeah.
Now, I would like to be the type of YouTuber that actually beats the monetization bug and actually gets text from Google.
That'd be cool. Right.
You know, he does that pretty much full time and also does other things. But now you have to have at least 500 subscribers.
And you still have
about 3,000 hours of watch time, whatever it is. And
70 grand. Cool.
So what happened to, let's see here. Oh, that's a bonus reward, 20. Oh yeah. So let's see what the car looks like. Oh, so that's it, huh? You know what? Let's inspect the vehicle. So there's the option to either sell the vehicle,
sell or scrap cars. It.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna sell the vehicle.
More money.
Yeah, that too is that I'm not really feeling and that, and I'm not really feeling the vehicle.
And but, you know that you only get 3 vehicles per week.
Exactly. Yep, 3 vehicles per week. So this is just like, you know, a real life kind of thing. Because so that means new vehicles are going to drop Tuesday. They're going to be on the want list. So we're selling it.
Right. Yeah, I think so, it's pretty cool. I mean, I was kind of bummed at first, but then now that I've started playing it and do some different stuff and everything, I think it's
yeah, because it's real. It's real. I like how they put the realism like this, you know. I actually like the realism alone here. So let's.
Oh, absolutely.
Let's make the delivery.
I say holla, you say dollar. Holla.
Dollar.
Okay. Cool. Let's get these wheels shipped to Yusuf. Head to terminal and drop it off. I told him all about the story behind it and everything. Vehicles. He is psyched for real, bro.
That's fine.
I mean, I was about to get. Like, when I did the first auto robbery, when I first did the auto delivery for Yusuf, I was about to get the full amount of money, except I was short $456 because I hit something. And I'm thinking, it's no big deal. I mean, it still got the top dollar. Like, $339,000, you know?
Right.
That's nothing. When I did the vehicle warehouse stuff for the CEO, and when I didn't have the resources, I ended up driving the vehicle, was shot up by the Vago Street Gang. They shot the shit out of it, right?
And right.
You know, I could barely get the car off the road. It's like the tires have been shot out. It's like that episode of The Simpsons where Homer's car ends up as part of, you know, gets eaten by Chuckasaurus, and it's a wreck that the muffler is dragging on the road.
Right.
Practically the driver. I mean, they shot everything out. And then when I delivered, it was embarrassing because the fact that you used all the money. That's why I use that cargo bob with the long cable hook to deliver the vehicle.
Right.
Because that way, I don't have to worry about gang members shooting up the vehicle.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. I learned that probably from TGG. When I looked at his content, you know, about stuff like investing in a cargo bomb and using that to deliver the vehicles.
Guess I'm gonna have to get back into TGG a little bit. Cause like I said, I went to this other server, and man, there's some good vibes in there, and I really liked it. But this one guy just kept making it. I don't know.
Of course.
So I ditched the server today, so everybody's. I told everybody in there to look. I'm just going back to my old ways. I got a whole bunch of friends on, on my list of Rockstar friends, and I just find me in a friend server. That's what I told them.
And slap Jamal. You come through and deliver the goods.
What is it? Go back to vibing with a lot of people, you know, not just a crew people.
And I want the next one to be a surprise very soon.
All right, man. Well, it was fun.
Keep it real,
baby. Keep it real.
Yeah, we'll see you next time.
Yep, see you next time.
All right, man. Later.
By the way, you can have your car back. Let me retire before some random event happens. All right? You can now have your car back. That was... Once again, I like to take this time to say if you are enjoying this stream, if you are enjoying the content I'm bringing you, why not like, follow, and subscribe to the Night to Live Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel for more Let's Play gaming live stream walkthroughs such as this. And if you feel like, if you feel generous and would like to contribute to my channel and contribute to me, I do have a Patreon listed in the description. Contribute if you like, or don't. Anyway, back with the game. We're only about 12 minutes to the end of the stream anyway. So this is the second vehicle. So thanks to one of my friends in the server, in the social club. Thanks for the hand. What was weird too is that my avatar was stuck. Like I couldn't move when we were doing the vehicle, when we were at the police station. And that was unfortunate. This is what I'm about to do. I'm gonna need to, respawn back at the salvage yard. I guess I'm gonna do a salvage mission and then end the stream. So I got 94.5 in the safe, and the maximum you can have is over 200, is up to $250,000. So meanwhile, I'm gonna do this quick repo.
So,
and then
has your heart rate lowered after we got our guy
see
out?
You around.
Cause my adrenaline I'm feeling is top tier, maybe need a hospital, you know?
So that's two cars off the board. And like I have mentioned too, you can only sell up to three of the listed vehicles. Once you've done that, that's it. So there's only one vehicle left on the board. I sell that, and that's all until next week, Tuesday. Meanwhile, I'm gonna go do a quick repo. Second player in the session, his private session. Oh, I got the car out of the way. That's two, that's all on the same screen. And that was the Gangbanger Robbery. Unfortunately, it's a bad one because my character avatar was stuck on the top on the road of the police station. That's some kind of weird glitch. More unfortunate. Originally, I was gonna keep the car for the show, but I figured I would have that moment, so I decided to sell it. Well, I'm gonna keep the vehicle and then I'm gonna come on the show. I'll be back on in the car for the main story of the Molotov. Thank you. this is literally drive-by still, especially when... He's tipped off the door. So this is practically the illegitimate version of JB's auto tow truck, only we're salvaging stolen cars and chopping the parts, stealing them off the street and salvaging the parts at the black market or pump. It's better than a taxi cab business.
Bring the car in. We'll salvage the parts and get paid in no time.
So you can bring up to 2 salvageable repos at a time. Because you only have 2 lifts anyway and 2 workers. And that's going to do it for this edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Grand Theft Auto Online, the Chop Shop
DLC. I'll be back tomorrow with episode 4 on the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And coming up at 3 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, I'll be streaming Grand Theft Auto 5 main story. So, until then, I'm Kill the Vid for the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And please, stay safe.